Welcome to part two of I Was Never Born Meditation. There is no better use of time, okay, than to insist that I was never born. I was never born. Very few people have ever even tried this, okay? But we're doing it right here. I was never born, all right? And we use, in the mood of repentance and the confession, that I have a severe continuity problem. So I'm very humble about whatever progress I can make. I understand it's going to take patience, forbearance. I understand there's going to be commotion, inner turmoil, and consternation inside, because I'm saying something that the collective belief system here doesn't admit to at all. So of course these are going to arise, and we're going to, with forbearance and humility and calm and stillness, we're going to ride out the earthquakes of consternation, because we're going to say, I don't have a consternation problem, I have a continuity problem. See, we're placing it in the right perspective. We just evaporate, let this evaporate, and see it as a continuity problem. Something that can be evaporated. And the more evaporation we do, the clearer we see. So we see, what we do is we're going to take the position that this is absolute fact. I've never been born. Absolute fact, I have never been born. In most retreats, they, you know, usually give at least 3 hours a day to meditation. And so most of us are not in retreats, day-to-day life scattered throughout the world. But through YouTube here, we can give the exact same effort, if not better, than those who are in monasteries, nunneries, retreats, cloistered somewhere away from the world. We absolutely can give tremendous effort and advance, make tremendous advancement. I woke up this morning and the realization was there, I have never been born. I have never been born. So I am just in the process of accepting this fact. So from the standpoint of truth, we state this from that standpoint, and we're stating it as if we're getting used to accepting it. So we say, it is absolutely clear to me that I've never been born. It is absolutely clear to me that I've never been born. There's shining clarity. The clarity that I have never been born is just shining. It is obvious. It is obvious that I've never been born. It is totally obvious that I've never been born. It is totally obvious that no one has ever been born. It is totally obvious that nothing has ever been born. Totally obvious to me. It is totally obvious to me that nothing has ever been born. So we are working, as we always do here, to get momentum until we start feeling this, that the consternation, the commotion, the turmoil, you know, the heat, the evaporation, the restructuring is taking place, and then we spend time in silence, just being present with that. We tolerate as much as we can tolerate. With determination that we have been living a lie for long enough. We have been living a lie for long enough. I have never been born. I have never been born. It's totally ridiculous to think that I could be born. Completely ridiculous to say that anyone could ever be born. Utterly absurd, actually. It is totally absurd to ever even remotely consider that anything could ever be born. Laughably absurd. It is totally self-evident that I've never been born. It is totally self-evident that I have never been born. Completely self-evident. And again, all of this is being said directly from spirit to spirit. Spirit is not holding a conversation with intellect. Spirit is simply reminding itself directly of truth. It is a laughable absurdity, a whimsical absurdity to suggest that anything could ever be born. It is a whimsical absurdity to even speak of birth. There is no such thing as birth. There is no such thing as birth. There is no such thing as birth. Okay, this is starting to sink in a little bit here. There is no such thing as birth. This doesn't exist. Birth doesn't exist. Birth does not exist. Spirit to spirit. Birth does not exist. Birth does not exist. Birth does not exist. Now, keep in mind, you may think, well, I'm viewing this on YouTube or listening to it, right? I think a lot of people listen to it, which is great. All over the world, actually. And you may think, well, what good can I do? I'm not in some traditional, I'm not some renunciate in orange robes and, you know, what would I do? Well, I would say that this meditation, this intensity is just as good as anything you're going to find anywhere in the world. I really believe that. Having viewed a lot of different services and satsangs and all of this, I said, this is just as good. This is just as potent, very potent. So absolutely you can make tremendous evaporation the continuity fear, okay? That's what I call progress, is we, our only block is the continuity fear, continuity problem. There's nothing else blocking us. If it weren't for that, phew, all delusion would instantly be gone. We'd see through it instantly. So all we're doing is evaporating this continuity fear, this continuity problem. And it's just a matter of doing it. It's not intellectual, it's doing it. And we are doing it here. So this is advanced. This is, you know, very advanced actually. So the time you spend in this intensity is actually doing a great deal to evaporate the continuity problem. Especially if you allow all these declarations to bypass the intellect and just feel it with your whole being. Feel it with your being. Not with your heart or emotions or body or anything. With your being. Allow your being. This is being speaking to being. Being has never been born. Being has never been born. Being cannot be born. And being is all that there is. All that there is cannot be born. All that there is cannot be born. Being cannot be born. I have never been born. No one has ever been born. Being has never been born. In fact, there's no such thing as birth at all. It's a silly, whimsical, idle wish. Okay, birth is a completely silly, idle wish that never, ever has any possibility of ever taking place under any circumstance. Under any circumstance, nothing can ever be born. Nothing has ever been born. Nothing has ever been born. That means everything right now is, all is, perfect, flawless. There are no cycles taking place actually at all. There are none. That's all an illusion. It's all an illusion. Same with karma. It's all an illusion. There is no karma. There are no cycles. There is no samsara. There is no layer. There are no layers and levels. None of that is true. It's all hallucination. It's all hallucination. I have never been born. So how could anyone have karma, right? That too is part of just a hallucination, a dream. No one has ever been born. No one has ever been born. All has always been residing within the perfect isness of all that is, without any possibility of it being otherwise. Without any possibility of it being otherwise. No one has fallen into any pit. No one has fallen from grace. There is no pit. It's a hallucination. We've been hallucinating there's a pit because we wanted to be greater than God, actually, is what's behind it. But we're not worried about that right now. We're just simply now stating fact about our situation. Fact. Never been born. There is no birth. We couldn't be born if we tried. We could not be born even if we tried. Even if that was a sole desire, okay, that we had, we could still never be born. We could still never take birth. We've never taken birth. We can never take birth. We can never take birth. Let this sink in. Let this sink in. I want to get this little fly moving on its way. Maybe it's having satsang, the flies. Is that like this? We can never take birth. There's no such thing as birth. We will never be able to take any birth. No one will ever take birth, okay? No one will ever take birth. Birth is not an option for us. Birth is not an option for us. There is no such option for us. None. Let that sink in. There's no such option as birth. Now, some of you may be trembling like a leaf. That is fine. You say, wow, this is great. Things are heating up. I feel more relaxed with this after the morning session here. This is the second session today. It's an all-out push. This is an all-out push right now. Birth is not an option for anyone. No one will ever, in all of creation, ever take a birth. It's never happened and never will happen. There is no such option. No option. We don't have that option. We do not have that option. What we've been doing is imagining we have some option that God hasn't given us, you know, to say, right? But again, there is no such option. Stay focused on stating fact here. I'm not going to try to get into too much theory here, at least at this point. We'll see if it's appropriate at some point. Now, if this is hitting hard, you manage that, right? You just manage it. Great. Just stay in the present with it. It's a great consternation. Wonderful. This is what it's all about. We want to bring consternation to our delusional beliefs, right? Our whimsicality. We want to bring consternation. And we're saying, hey, that's it. I'm seeing through it. This is it. It's over. Get ready. Get ready. Beliefs. Belief system. Get ready. This is the proper belief system. And we do have a proper belief system until we drop all belief altogether. But that's far, far down the road, as it were. We're not interested in that. We're interested in aligning proper belief. Remember, it's not like we can take birth, but we decided not to. There's no such thing as birth. Spirit cannot be born. Spirit cannot be born. Being cannot be born. All that is cannot be born. All that is. All that is. All that is. There's no birth in isness. There's no point where isness is not. All right? There's no point ever where isness is anything other than isness. It's always isness. And everything, all is. there is anything else. There isn't anything else. There is no such thing as birth, ever, anywhere. So no one has ever taken birth. No one has ever taken birth. No. Therefore, we cannot end the cycles of birth, right? Because there's never been any birth. This is very important. This is something that may shock you a little bit. People are used to thinking like, this is going to be my final life. I know I've talked like that too, we all do. Like, I want to end the cycles of birth and death. But actually, from the position of the Absolute, which is what we are waking up to, what we are realizing here, is that I've never been born. There were no cycles of birth and death. There's nothing to end. There's nothing to bring to an end. There's nothing to bring to an end. Okay, there's no karma. There's no cycles of birth and death. Nothing has ever happened. Nothing ever started. Nothing ever began. Nothing ever began at all. All has always been. All has always, all always is. All always is. There's no beginning, there's no ending to isness. All always is. So, there have never been any cycles. That's all been a hallucination. An idle wish, actually. Jesus says it's an idle wish. It's all just been an idle wish. There's no way to end it because it never began. There's no need for an end to it. There's no need to say, this is my final life. Final life. I was never born. So, see, the whole issue of final disappears when you realize you can never be born. And that's what brings up consternation in our being right now, in our belief system. It's like we're so been going to finalize. I got to end it. I got to end this. And now we realize that there's no end because there was never any beginning. There's never been any birth. There's no cycles to end, and it never happened. Never happened. It was just our interpretation, misinterpretation, misperception, desire, whim, hallucination, wishful thinking, magical belief. None of it was true. Nothing has ever been born. So, our belief system needs to shift from dualistic beginning and ending to non-dual. No beginning, no ending, no birth, no cycles, no attainment. No realization. There's nobody on a path that realized, you know, that no, I'm finally I reached the end of the path. I'm finally free of these cycles of birth and death, and I've, you know, I've awakened to that. That in that way, there's no realizer in that way. Realization comes that nothing ever happened, so there doesn't need to be a realizer. Okay, there isn't a realizer. The realization might be the realization free realization. The realization free realization. It's just awareness of isness. Awareness of isness. Awareness of isness. Or just isness. Just isness. That's all. Just isness. No realizer of isness. No realizer of isness. No attainer of isness. No enlightenment of isness. No reaching isness. No grasping isness, no understanding isness, just isness. the unborn one. The is the unborn oneness. The unborn oneness is all there is. Unbirthable isness. The unbirthable isness is. The unbirthable isness is. The unbirthable isness is. Keep your mind absolutely simple. Just focused on the general consternation, generally how you feel. Don't get sophisticated or clever or run, start running with it. Now just stay right here. It's enough to, for this to, this churning. They say that meditation works the way, same way churning milk produces butter. This churning, this consternation, results in recognition, realization, or the realization free realization, the recognition free recognition. There's nobody who's been born who is realizing this. Okay, this is a way of putting it. There isn't anybody who's been on a path realizing this. There isn't anyone who's been born realizing. It's not like there's somebody who's been born who's realizing that they were never born. See, that's not it. It's that there hasn't ever been it. There hasn't been birth ever anywhere. It's never happened. It was like a silly dream we've been having. And don't struggle trying to understand. Just let it impact. Let spirit respond to this, because we spirit will just be saying yes, 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 yes. So just from this morning effort, I can feel there's a lot less struggle and consternation. It's already, alignment is taking place already. So you see, the progress can come that quickly, actually. Take a little break, had some lunch, took a little nap, and now, you know, I feel like, wow, it's not as difficult as before. So forging ahead like that, forging ahead. So perhaps we are preparing for a great celebration, like, aha, I've been through so many lives, and I finally have earned merit, so I know it won't be born ever again, you know. We've been thinking that, and now we hear, oh, I'm seeing that I was never born. I never went through any lives. Nothing ever happened. There's only been the isness, always. There's never been anything other than that. And the shock is like, oh my gosh, how foolish I was. So we're kind of getting over that consternation, like, oh my gosh, I would have been real, that would, how foolish have I been, how foolish. Well, sure, entertaining an idle wish is foolish, but that's okay, because we just wanted to see what that was like, that's all. So I wonder if we could just, I wonder what happens if we just deny what we are. What's that like? So in some ways, spirit is enjoying this awakening, sort of from the dream, from hallucinating, realizing that it never has gone anywhere. There's nowhere it can go. There's nowhere it can go to be born. Spirit can't be born. Spirit cannot be born. Spirit cannot be born. Spirit doesn't have any beginning or ending, independent of all of creation. Another, right? There's no separation there at all. Separation has been what it is, always. And just check in here with how we feel right now, the strain of it all. So let's go back to, it's completely clear to me that birth is impossible. It's completely clear to me that birth is impossible. It is absolutely clear to me that birth is impossible. It is totally self-evident to me that birth is impossible. It is completely obvious that birth is impossible. It's absolutely clear to me that birth is impossible. It is totally self-evident. That birth is impossible. It is totally self-evident that birth is impossible. So say this with conviction, with conviction, with conviction. Not like a debate. You're not debating anyone. You're simply reminding yourself of the truth. It is totally obvious. It's a fact, is it not? It's totally obvious. In the awakened condition, right? And that's the condition we are going into now. So to prepare for that, we need to know what is it that we're going to experience when we stop hallucinating. Well, we're going to experience it totally obvious that birth is impossible. That's what we're going to see. That is what we're going to see. So we're rehearsing what it is that we're going to see. So when we see it, we say, of course, that's what I expected. That's what I expected. Oh, this is it. No problem. See, we're aligning our expectations with what we are going to experience as we awaken. And we're going to say, oh, it's totally obvious. Oh, it's totally obvious birth is impossible. Totally self-evident that birth is impossible. We will see that. We will know it. It will be completely self-evident to us. So we are in the process, as it were, of gently drifting into that. And since it's completely obvious, we don't need a thought to think about it, do we? It is totally self-evident. It's obvious that birth is impossible. It's completely obvious that birth is impossible. Completely obvious. Now, to someone who's hallucinating birth, it's not obvious at all, right? Of course, but we're no longer hallucinating. So to us, it's completely obvious. And everyone else doesn't have a hallucination problem. They have a continuity problem. So you don't get pulled into struggling with hallucination. You're only dealing with the continuity problem. It's the only problem there is. This helps you out in dealing with other people. Okay, you must be centered in that, in your own self. The only problem there is the continuity problem. And see, the whole world, everyone that way, because this is true. This is true. Without that, it would be completely self-evident to everyone. There's no such thing. Birth is impossible. It's completely self-evident. Birth is impossible. Nobody really wants to keep hallucinating, okay? They're just afraid to drop it because of the continuity fear. Now, hallucination is terrible. It's really terrible. And so you're not aware of the isness, which is all. You're not aware of it. You feel that you've somehow been, you know, forsaken. And that's terrible. And then you desperately try to compensate for that. So nobody wants to keep hallucinating. So the only thing stopping them from relinquishing hallucination is the continuity fear. That's it. There isn't any other reason whatsoever. Continuity fear is a broad term, okay? It's a broad umbrella. It's a big umbrella. Just keep it simple. It is just this fear, like, whoa, you know, what's gonna happen when I stop hallucinating? Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh. What am I going to see? What am I going to realize? I know it's so completely different, right? Well, sure. We've been believing in birth all this time, and now we're here. It's totally obvious birth is impossible. Totally obvious birth is impossible. Well, that's a huge turnaround from what we've been believing, right? So our belief system, Jesus says what we need to do is exchange the belief system of the ego, which is the belief system of hallucination, for the belief system of the Holy Spirit, which is the belief system of non-hallucination. Make that exchange. But it has to be a gentle exchange, as it were. And we have every right to rehearse the new belief system, get used to it. We're getting used to it. So as we awaken, we will see, it's totally obvious birth is impossible. Totally obvious birth doesn't exist. Totally obvious that nothing's ever been born. I'm seeing, everything I see is completely obvious. Nothing's ever been born. There is no such thing as birth. There's only isness. This moment, totally obvious. There's only the present isness. So we're recalibrating our expectations here, getting our whole system used to this. Because you cannot just say, here, take a new belief system, boom. It's so utterly different than the one we've had, of hallucination, right? It'd be too much for us. So we have to put this work in. We have to put the work in. So we're dealing with total fact here, not conjecture. There is no birth. Everything I see, it's so obvious. The truth of non-birth is so completely obvious to me now. The truth of non-birth is completely obvious to me now. Wow. The truth of non-birth is completely obvious to me right now. Effortlessly obvious. It is all effortlessly obvious. Nothing's ever been born. There is no such thing as birth. It's completely obvious to me now. I see it everywhere. There's nowhere where this truth is not. Truth is everywhere. 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 The truthless truth is everywhere. You know, it's not truth here and truth there. It's the truthless truth. Whereas we, you know, there's no location or no concept location. Truth is everywhere. It's completely self-evident. Totally self-evident. The self-evident free self-evidency of truthless truth in the everywhere free everywhereness of the now free nowness. That actually produced a burn in me, because we're totally unused to using language in that way. You see, the way we use language is based on hallucination and the hallucinatory belief system we have, the belief system about hallucination. That's the way we use language, actually. So using language tends to subtly reinforce, you know, delusion, continuity fear. So when we change the use of language like we're able to do here, that really puts a burn on us, for sure. In fact, the video that I did, made the breakthrough about the I am and am not, the Jesus free Jesus, that caused a near breakdown in me. It was so profound, you know, so shocking, stunning. So I have to sort of sprinkle this in like seasoning. It's possible to do too much. It is possible to do too much too fast in terms of language. I feel that use of language, it produces just this most tremendous burn in us, because we're so used to communicating with words and language, right, and concepts, that to use language in a totally different way like this just fries us. It just knocks us out, which is great, but it's possible to overdo it. But there, we should include it in every video. I really should include some of this so you get used to it. Birth free. That and not that. That and not that. Yeah, that and not that. Yes, that. Yes, not that. Yes, that. Yes, not that. Yes, that. Yes, not that. And we're saying, well, what am I supposed to be hallucinating? What am I supposed to be hallucinating? See, it tends to stop the hallucination. Full stop the hallucination. Right, wait. Yeah, yes, that. Yes, not that. Yes, that. Yes, not that. Yes, that and yes, not that. And yes, that and yes, not that. As it is and isn't. As it is and as it isn't. As it is and as it isn't. Birth freeness. In other words, birth freeness. The self-evident free self-evidency. A birth freeness. We say, wow, I don't know what I'm supposed to hallucinate. Exactly. We don't need to hallucinate to know reality. Reality is not a hallucination. Reality is not an hallucination. Reality is not an hallucination. Reality does not need to hallucinate. Reality does not need to hallucinate. Reality does not need to hallucinate. I am birthless. I am birthless. I am birthless. I am the birthlessness. I am birthless. Give a little time for those this is putting the stress, putting the strain, putting the pressure on, as it were, which is, we know we have to do this now. The world is putting the pressure on us to an unbelievable extent, actually. And we must not try to measure it, okay? Above all else, do not try to take measure of the world at this point, okay? Do not try to take measure of the world at this point. This is difficult for everyone, difficult for me. That time is over. We've done that. And just trust your measurements. You've already taken the measurements of it. Okay? And you know it's another cycle. Another hallucinatory cycle is being shoved down everyone's throats. Okay? We already know that. That's all you need to know. And then you say, well, I'm not going there. I'm not doing that. That's all that needs to be known. Because we know there's no such thing as birth. There's no such thing as any cycle. There are no cycles. So why do I want to be in a hallucination of separation, believing there are cycles, when there isn't any? When I can easily state there are no cycles, there are no births, there is no time, there is no karma, there is no separation, there is no delusion, There is no hallucination. Reality doesn't need deep dreaming. Reality doesn't need cycles. Reality doesn't need bursts. Reality doesn't need reality. Reality is. Reality is the isness free isness. The isness free isness free isness free isness. Birth is impossible. Birth is impossible. It's not even an option. There is no option. It's obvious to me there is no option of birth. There is no option of cycles. I've never been cycling anywhere. I've never gone through anything. I've never gone through anything. I never went on a journey. See, this is the confession of one who's waking up from a dream, isn't it? And what you do is you don't try to understand the dream. At some point you realize, oh, that was just a dream, it never happened. So that's where we're at. That's where we're at. We're not trying to figure out, what is that, you know, where do I go, and how did I, you know, avoid this and that. We're coming out of that now, and we're saying, wow, I never went anywhere. I never went anywhere. I never did anything. I never went anywhere. This is allowing you to let go of the dream, right? The content no longer matters at all. There was no content. There never was any content, okay? In the dream, there never was any content whatsoever. There was no birth. There was no death. There was no cycles. There was no journey. There was no content. Nothing ever happened. Nothing ever happened. Nothing ever happened. All right. This is shocking enough. I would just let it settle in. Sometimes there's no need to repeat, really. You just feel the barrage. Feel the barrage. It's like, wow. It's like filtered sunlight. The sunlight is filtering through a tree here. And so even though the sunlight is right there, we're not getting that, you know, direct. It's not hitting us too terribly at all. There's some bokeh effect here of the soft light. So I'm looking right towards the sun, but again, there's some tree leaves that are filtering it out, which is nice. So here we are, you know, looking directly at truth, but it feels in a filtered way because we're still absorbing it. There's all our beliefs are still kind of like leaves, filtering it out a little bit. But we're trimming it. We're trimming some branches, you know, like we're trimming a tree bit by bit, allowing more light in. And day by day we get used to it and say, wow, I love this light. More light, more light, more light. More light, more light, more light. I love this more light, more light, more light. I love this more light, more light, more light. And we're taking a big branch off right now, actually. So there's going to be more sunlight than not, you see. That's like a big sort of shift. Wow. No one has ever been born. No one has ever been born. Just because there are many spirits that are hallucinating doesn't mean that they've been born. Doesn't mean they've been born at all. Just because they believe they have doesn't mean they have at all. They have not. Nothing's ever been born. This is not high teaching, it's not low teaching or anything. It's just statement of fact. Just statement of fact, simple statement of fact. It's completely obvious to me and to everyone else. It's totally obvious to all that there's no such thing as birth. That there's only the isness, this perpetual, eternal isness. There's only the eternal isness. There's only this eternal isness. There's only this. THIS. The is. This. The is. This. There's only the is of this. There's only the is of this. There is only the is of this. There is only the is of this. Now, you might be saying, I don't see it. We're rehearsing for what we're going to see. We will see this as the last reverberations of the hallucination dissipate, and we let it all go without measuring or thinking about the content or anything that happened. We don't have to think about anything that happened. Nothing happened. Nothing happened. So what is there to think about? Nothing ever took place. Did I move from where I am? No. Did I change what I am? No. So what took place? Nothing took place. Nothing took place. It was much ado about nothing. It was truly much ado about nothing. Sometimes you reach flat spots, a little flat spot, that's fine. You can't, you're not going to be going 100% all the time. A little flat spot, feel a little tired, that's okay. The momentum is still there. It's like surfing, you catch a wave, you ride it in. It tends to lessen as it goes closer to shore. But oftentimes there's another break that you can keep going and catch it as it sort of reforms, the swell reforms, hits another sandbar, another underwater formation that causes it to break, and then you can ride that in, you know, all the way to shore. So sometimes the intensity drops a little bit. But stay on the board. There's the active part of the meditation, and there's the inactive part. The active part is, you know, getting these clarifications, declarations, affirmations. And then the quiet part, the inactive part, is just letting that sit. Let the consternation, let everything settle, sort out, settle down of its own accord. It's like throwing a stone into a pool. The ripples are there. Once the ripples are there, you know, you just have to let it all settle down. It'll settle down on its own, right? The effort is to take that stone and throw it in. Or you could also say to take a stone out of a pond. You're taking a big stone out, and that causes, you know, ripples. Either way, it's just the principle is that the ripples will subside gradually subside. Without us doing anything, we just have to sit there calmly and allow it to happen. Ultimately, we see there is no pool. There are no ripples can happen at all. There's no ripples that can happen to isness. There's no instability that can happen to it. There's no birth that can happen to isness. There's no instability. It can happen to anything, actually. Okay, there is no instability that can happen to anything. A lack of relative functioning is not an instability in relation to what is, to its isness. The isness of all can never be unstable, can never take any birth. Isness is not functionality, as we term it. Isness is isness. It's the eternal presence of all. So we need to rehearse, how are we going to view when we finally lose all interest in the hallucination, hallucinating, and whatever we thought, whatever we were hallucinating, lose interest in that. We lose interest in that. So all is. Entirely present. All is entirely present. All is entirely present. All is the unborn one. All is the unborn, unbornness everywhere. All I'm seeing is unbornness, total unbornness. So say that all I am seeing is total unbornness. There's only this unbornness. Don't push too hard on that, though. Don't. Let's not, that tends to almost overwhelm us. We can touch upon it. The unborn, unborn, unbornness. All is unborn. Say, all is unborn. All is unborn. All is unborn right now. 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 The unborn unbornness right now. All is unborn. All is unborn. All is unborn. Wow, we're going to be walking. Everywhere we go, we see the total fresh unbornness of everything. That's all there is, the fresh unbornness. The unmeasurable unbornness, the immeasurable, the measurement-free unbornness, the fresh measurement-free. See, it's completely fresh. It's always that way. There's nothing to measure. Everything is abiding in pure spaciousness, 100%, always. There's nothing to measure. They're not images to measure, increments to measure. There's no increments whatsoever. Isness has no increments. Isness is increment free. The increment free isness that is always unborn. The unborn increment free isness of the now free nowness, of the here free here-ness, of the everywhere free everywhere-ness, of the reality, the need free reality free reality. The need-free reality, free reality. So hang in there. We're not done. We're in a crisis. The world's in a crisis, so we are too in that regard. What we can say is, hey, what I see is crisis-free. What I see is crisis-free. What I see is crisis-free. What I see is crisis-free isness. What I see is crisis-free. All I see is crisis-free. All I see is crisis-free. All I see is birth-free. All I see is crisis-free. 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 Now don't try to see it. Keep affirming it. Keep declaring it. Keep expecting it. All I see is crisis-free. 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 Keep in mind that continuity fear holds the memory of hallucination in place, so to speak, and so don't be disturbed if you say, well, I don't see it. It's there. It's there to be seen. It's just that we have to let go of the hallucinating. All I see is crisis-free. All I see is crisis-free. All I see is crisis-free. There is only the unborn one. There is only the unborn one. There is only the unborn oneness. There is only the unborn oneness. My family is birth free. I belong to the birth free family, and that's the only family there is. I belong to the one birth free family. All is birth free. 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 Now, we might be wondering, how come we can't be more successful at this? Because of the continuity fear. So, of course, we're uptight. Absolutely. We're not free and easy and flowing, right? Of course not. Because we are working on this tremendous turnaround here. And it's bringing up tremendous consternation. So it may seem others in the world are free and flowing and say, wow, they're so much more spiritual than I am, but they may not be working on this, these very all-important work that has to be done. So they're only seem to be flowing in a very limited context here, okay? So don't compare yourself with anyone. If you are doing this, if you are saying, hey, all I see is birth free, It's totally evident to me that everything is birth-free. What I see is crisis-free. What I see is birth-free. It's totally obvious birth is impossible. If you're working on this, can't be doing anything better. Can't be doing anything better, really. And so temporarily, of course, we're going to feel constricted and because we're this tremendous consternation is arising, like wow. But that's the price we pay for freedom from hallucinating, freedom from hallucination. That's the price we pay. So be willing to pay the price. Be willing to pay the price. Many have been willing throughout the ages, as it were, the age-free ages, the ages that never were, never will be. Isness doesn't have cycles to it, right? How could it? everything that is at this moment is, both manifest and unmanifest, entirely, 100%, completely present, completely is. There's no cycling there. It's all 100%. Always, always 100%. Reality is always 100%. Reality doesn't need birth. Reality doesn't need birth. Reality doesn't need birth. So, meditation is a marathon. Meditation is a marathon. Really, just be a marathon runner. There's nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that. It's a mindset. Marathoner gets up in the morning, they're training. They may run 10 miles, right? For them, it's no big running 10 miles. It's no big thing at all. They may run 15 miles. And to do that every day, and then running a marathon is not so bad. It is a strain, sure, but I say, yeah, sure, it's no problem. It's just a mindset. Now, if I had been into running, I'm sure I would have, you know, been a marathoner or something like that. It's just the challenge of it, and let's do something. Let's really, you know, get after it here. But I wasn't a runner. I could not run very well. I tried, and it wasn't me. Meditation is a marathon. Go into it with that expectation. It's not some just little sprint, not a 5-minute sprint. Don't let the fish off the hook. When you hook the fish, you got to bring it all the way in, and you got to net the fish. You know, don't say, oh, I caught a fish, and then, oh, it got away. Yeah, oh, well. Don't let it get away. Maybe the fish is playing, you know, playing possum. Just stay with it. Stay with it. The fish is still on the line. Fish is still on the line. The inside is still there. Clarification is still there. I was never born. 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 There's no such thing as birth. There is no such thing as birth. I couldn't be born if I tried to. There's no way to even try to be born. There is no way to even try to be born. There is no way to even try to be born. I see very clearly there's no way to even try to be born. There is absolutely no way to even try to be born. None whatsoever. None whatsoever. No one, none whatsoever. See, now this is a shock to those of us who believe, who have been believing in this whole notion of cycles, layers and levels, progressivism, salvation through works, all of this massive belief system. When you see there's no way to even try to be born, not in the slightest way can I even try to be born. You know, the belief system will say, well, how can I earn merit then? I mean, how can I earn merit? How can I burn karma up? How can I, you know? It's stunning and shocking, isn't it? So, of course, to see this is stunning and shocking. But we've been progressively letting go of progressivism. Progressively letting go of progressivism. Now, see, if we get disoriented with words, we need to practice that and realize, I can't possibly be disoriented. There's no such thing as disorientation. There's nowhere where I can go where I'm not exactly where I've always been. There's nowhere where I can ever go where I'm not still not exactly where I've always been. Okay, let's see. There's nowhere that I can ever go where I'm not exactly where I've always been. And by the way, thank the Holy Spirit for these declarations. There's nowhere that I can ever go where I'm not exactly where I've always been. I don't have notes, I don't plan this out. Most of the time there's nothing. And just suddenly it occurs, you know, this to say this, that's all. It's the spirit within us that is helping us. It's the one spirit that we all are that is talking to itself. There is nowhere that I can ever go where I'm not exactly where I've always been. There's nowhere I can ever go where I'm not exactly where I've always been. There's nowhere I can ever go where I'm not exactly where I've always been. There's nowhere anything can ever go where it's not exactly where it's always been. There's nowhere I can ever go where I'm not exactly where I've ever been. There's nowhere anything can ever go where it's not exactly where it's always been. There's nowhere that all can go where it's not exactly where it's always been. There's nowhere that everything can go where it's not exactly where it's always been. There's nowhere I can ever go where I'm not exactly where I've always been. Now this is very stunning, very stunning, very powerful. I've never heard this one before. Wow, thank you, Holy Spirit. There is nowhere that I can ever go where I just let it drop, right? You get it. Words are dropping away. There's nowhere where I can ever go where I'm not where I've always been. There is absolutely nowhere I can ever, ever go where I will not be exactly where I have always, always, always been. So how can I take birth? How can I take birth? There is no birth. There is nowhere that I can ever go where I'm not exactly where I've always been. There is nowhere I can ever go where I'm not exactly where I've always been. There's not anywhere that anything can go where it's not exactly where it's always been. There is nowhere that anything can go. Absolutely nowhere where anything can ever go. There is absolutely nowhere that anything can ever go where it is not exactly where it's always been. Now, this is just a mind stopper. I didn't expect to come upon this. You know, this is even a more ultra declaration than anything I've come across. This is just... This is like a Maha mantra. This is a very, there is nowhere where anything can ever, ever go where it is not exactly where it has always been. And where is that? Of course, pure spaciousness. So how could we say that anything could possibly ever take birth? Take birth, take birth. No. How could everything that's always exactly where it's always been be said to be taking birth? What kind of meaning does that have? It doesn't have any meaning. You see, the benefit of a meditation marathon, the benefit is these new insights suddenly emerge. Wow, this is tremendous. I mean, this declaration is so astonishing. I don't want to even measure, try to just simply let it be, just let it be, just let it be. Don't read anything into it. Just let it be. It will do its work. It will do its work. There is nowhere I can ever go, nowhere where I can ever, ever go where I'm not exactly where I've always been. There is nowhere where anything can ever go where it's not exactly where it's always been. So, do not anticipate, do not say, how's this going to work out? Just let it be, just let it be. But I can tell you, this one has certainly got my attention of the belief system. It's really, the whole belief system is just like on full alert. There is nowhere where anything can ever go where it's not exactly where it's always been. This is a total fact. This is one of those that it's easy to just kind of drift off away from it because it's so profound. It really, the belief system is just doesn't know, you hardly know what to, how to respond or anything to this. It's just stuff. So we remain sitting quietly. It's a great blessing to get this, great blessing, great blessing. There's nowhere where I can ever go where I'm not exactly where I've always been. full alert. Police system is on full alert right now. It's like full attention. That's an attention getter. Because this just knocks out the belief system of hallucination, just knocks it out. Extinguishes, like is this like a, you know, candle extinguisher. It's like a nirvana mantra. Declaration of nirvana, really. Remember, we don't reach nirvana, we've always been there. There's no place else. No matter where you ever go, you're always in nirvana. There's absolutely nowhere I could ever go where I'm not exactly where I've always been. Which is nirvana. Which is the kingdom of heaven. Which is reality, which is the zero dimensionality, which is the pure spaciousness. Which is the everywhere, everywhereness, which is the isness, which is the freedom, which is the love, which is the pure, pure happiness, which is the traceless love, freedom, pure happiness, trace-free, trace-freeness. The absolutely serene and majestic and all smooth smoothness. Of the freedom, free freedom. Of the pure purity of pure happiness. The pure purity of pure happiness. There's nowhere where I can ever go where I'm not exactly where I've always been. There's nowhere where I can ever go where I'm not exactly where I've always been. So this is worthy of our time, is it not? This statement is, this declaration, this affirmation is worthy of our time. Absolutely worthy of it. So I'm not going to give up on it here. Because the belief system is saying, wow. I don't know about this. And maybe it's too much. But out of respect and honor, if we're going to respect and honor anything, this is it. There's nowhere I can ever go where I'm not exactly where I've always been. That's like a bigger bonfire, isn't it? Wow. That's going to heat things up. There is absolutely nowhere where anything can ever go where it's not exactly where it's always been. Obviously, this frees us from the whole insanity of relativity, of duality, does it not? Absolutely it does. It's a declaration of nirvana is what it is. It is a declaration of nirvana. It's saying, this is nirvana. This, the is nirvana. The is is this. You don't have to do anything with this. We just say it, all right? We just stay exactly in the practice, all right? This is important. We just stay exactly in the same practice. It's working. We don't have to say, oh, okay, now I made a breakthrough. Now I'm going to do something different. Now you just stay exactly in the same practice, calm, humble. Obviously, we have the declaration of truth, which is stunning. But we also have a continuity fear, right? So don't lose our patience just because you say, well, I should be able to awaken now. No. Continuity fear is preventing that. So we don't make the mistake of saying, well, gee, if I don't awaken right now, maybe that none of this is true. Maybe this isn't working. Maybe. No, it is working. It's absolutely working. And just getting to this point means what we're doing something extraordinarily effective. Just getting to this declaration means we're doing something astonishingly effective. What we're doing is astonishingly effective. And all we're doing is we're putting a little more time honoring our effectiveness, really. You see, the spiritual path, really, the effort we're putting in is a way of honoring spirit. Spirit honoring spirit. Spirit saying, you know, spirit, I know you're going to wake up, so to speak. I'm honoring my knowing that you will awaken from you will cease hallucinating. You will cease hallucinating. It's like I say about Jesus. What a tremendous honor Jesus did to us by giving A Course in Miracles, Journey Beyond Words, by coming into the world as Jeshua Jesus 2,000 years ago or so. And saying to us, hey, I know you're going to get this. I trust, I know that you, what I'm teaching, what I'm saying, you're going to get it. And so he gave us tremendous, tremendous teaching. I was like, wow, how in the world can I get that? That just seems to be way beyond me. And yet here's Jesus saying, no, I'm putting my trust in you, I'm honoring you. It's spirit honoring spirit is what he did. Spirit honoring spirit. That's what we're doing here. We spend the time to get the effectiveness because we know we will drop hallucination. We will drop hallucination. We will drop this relativistic nonsense. So by putting in the time, we're saying, I know I'm going to get it. I know I'm spirit. I know I'm free. I know I'm still as God created me. So I know I'm going to get this. There's no doubt about it. And I'm honoring that knowing. I'm honoring the knowing. Honor the knowing. Honor the knowing. And we are getting it. There's absolutely no place whatsoever where I can ever go where I'm not exactly where I've always been. I've never been born. Therefore, I've never been born. No one's ever been born. Nothing's ever been born. Nothing can ever be born. Nothing can ever be born. Nothing can ever be born. Now, sure, we could go off now and do something else. I could stop and say, well, let the cat indoors, go about doing fixed dinner. I said, sure, could do that. But let's spend some more time honoring the fact where we've gotten to here. This is a big deal. This is a very big deal. So we're absolutely going to honor it. We'll honor this. When you hit a milestone like this, you recognize it, and just this is a big, big deal. This is a super attention getter. So we don't bail on it. Don't bail on it. Honor yourself and honor yourself, spirit, honoring spirit. Don't say, well, okay, I got it. No, give it more honor than that. If you don't honor this, what will you honor is the question, right? Nothing. If this doesn't deserve honor, what does? You know, there's absolutely nowhere that I can ever go where I'm not exactly where I've always been. There's no way that this tree can grow. There's no way that this tree can ever go where it's not exactly where it's always been. There's no way this world can ever turn where it's not exactly where it's always been. There's no way that anyone can ever go, no place that anyone can ever go where they're not exactly where they've always been. There's nowhere this universe can ever go where it's not exactly where it's always been. There's no place that I can ever go to, right? No place I can go to where I'm not exactly where I've always been. Bears repeating. There's nowhere that anyone can go where they're not exactly where they've always been. There is nowhere anyone can ever go where they're not exactly where they have always been and always will be. You see, this is a shift. This is the shift, right? Starting to see just little edges of the shift, as it were. It's a new perspective on everything. A very profound new perspective, but don't force it. Don't force it. We don't force here. We marathon here, but we don't force. So whatever comes up is the result of this patience and the effort, it will just arise, you know, it'll just, one moment it'll just be there. I say, okay, I was expecting you. I was expecting this, that's great. Or at least in somewhat expecting along these lines, although it's not, you know, yeah, it's stunning, it's shocking, but that's fine, that's good because I have this practice, no problem. Let it sink in, let it settle in. It's like the dawn. You see, the dawn, something's coming over the hills. It's the dawn. Don't get ahead of yourself. Say, okay, it's the dawn. Okay, great. I expected the dawn to come along at some point here. Here it comes. Okay, fine. It's like that. Here comes the dawn. Here comes the dawn of realization. Fine. Meanwhile, sit here quietly. Be aware of the consternation. As they say, the light replaces the dark effortlessly, does it not? So don't worry about it. I gotta try to get rid of that light. I know, let the dawn come, and then the light, the darkness will be gone of it automatically. So we just keep affirming and declaring, and then let the darkness disappear. Let the light vanish, you know, vanish the darkness. let us not turn away from the dawn and be struggling with the darkness. So what do I do? How do I get rid of this? Oh, forget it. Forget it. Don't need to struggle like that. Here comes the dawn. Here comes the dawn. Here comes the dawn. Here comes the dawn of realization. Here comes the dawn of realization. Just let that sink in. Here comes the dawn of realization. Here comes the dawn of realization. Here comes the dawn of realization. Getting little tinges of it right now. Wow. The vision of oneness, just the tremendous happiness and relief. Oh my gosh. Everything is okay. Everything is perfectly okay. Everything is, there's no problem at all. See, it's starting to get tinges of that, little tinges. Again, don't struggle. Just let the little tinges come. If they don't come, fine too. That's okay too. And just stay present with, oh, here comes the dawn. Okay, here comes the dawn of realization. Great. And if, notice the tinges. If the tinges arise, just notice them. Okay, noticed it. And that's enough. Just notice it. Okay, fine. Noticed it. Here comes the dawn. Now I'm seeing the dawn of realization. Now I am seeing the dawn of realization. No judgment, no labels, just fact, just statement. Now I'm seeing the dawn of realization, okay? Be saying faster, needed faster. Yeah. Yeah, don't do that. It's big enough. It's big enough for right now. It's big enough. I say don't look a gift horse in the mouth. Don't look a gigantic shift like this. Don't say oh, okay, I got it. No, it's big enough for the moment. It is big enough for the moment. Give it your full attention, your full effort. Here comes the dawn of realization. That's big enough for this moment, isn't it? Here comes the dawn of realization. Mind might get distracted from this. That doesn't take away of the enormity from it. So bring yourself back to the enormity of it. Don't say, oh, I got distracted. Okay, there's no enormity there. No, it's a total enormity is here. The dawn of realization is here. The dawn of realization is here. There is absolutely nowhere that I can ever go where I'm not exactly where I've always been. Force it on yourself. Okay, just be aware it's there. That's the dawn, okay? It's so potent that if you try to force it on yourself, you might start reacting to it in negative ways. state the fact. Here comes the dawn of realization. Here it comes. Alright. Just sit back. Here comes the dawn of realization. Wow. Great. Give yourself this quiet time. Give yourself some quiet time here. Just to stay with it. Just honor it. So practice this honoring where you don't disengage just because the mind seems to be losing interest. There's some higher principle here, right, than the mind's interest. This is the dawning of realization. This is the dawning of realization. The mind might want to go off and do something else, but you say no mind, we're gonna sit here. Even if you're restless, we're gonna still sit here. Even if you're restless, see, put that stipulation there. No matter what, we're gonna still sit here. Whether the insights are flowing or not, whether the mind's restless or not, whether we think we're effective or not, doesn't matter. We're going to honor the dawn of realization here. And you will find what I find is an upwelling of gratitude from Spirit by just saying this. Spirit, there's something in us that is truly grateful for this. It's no matter what, we are going to honor this. Very important. Just sit. It's okay just to sit. We're just hanging out. I'm trying to change the light of this. It doesn't want to. Oh, there you go. So there is this wonderful time where we've done the work and we feel okay. Wow. Did it. Fantastic. Then we spend time honoring the work we've done, honoring the breakthroughs, honoring this. We don't say, okay, let's take off now. No. See, we use our will to say, no, we're going to honor what we've done here and just hang out. Absolutely just hang out. Here comes the dawn of self-realization. Here comes the dawn of realization. Here it comes. Here it comes. It just announced its presence. It just announced its presence here. Unmistakably. And so honor its presence. Honor the presence. It's announced its presence. It gave us its calling card. It says, here I come. You're ready. Here we come. Here it is. Here it comes. Here comes the dawn. Here comes the dawn. So, if I can shift over here and let the... Okay, I'll bump this up just one little notch like that. Okay, there we go. So... So Spirit gave us its calling card, its business card. It means business. Here's my business card. There is absolutely nowhere I can ever go where I will not be exactly where I've always been. That's the calling card of Spirit right there. And we got to it by practicing this birth. I've never been born. There's no such thing as birth. I've never been born. That generated momentum, you see, for then this breakthrough. So Spirit means business now. Here comes the dawn of realization. Here comes the dawn of realization. Very important part of the meditation, okay? Which is why my videos run longer than most. Very important time. Cannot skip this time. Cannot skip it. It's so important. Ordinarily, you might think of this time, there's chit-chat, drinks, food, snacks, people getting ready to leave, you know, and getting ready. No, we're not doing that. We're using the time just to sit here quietly and honor the presence of Spirit, the dawning of realization. Honor the dawning of realization. Even though we might be tired, and again, I may not be so into it because we've put a lot of effort forth. Stay present with the situation. Stay present. Honor your success. Trust in your success. Spirit believes in Spirit. Spirit knows that Spirit will succeed. Spirit is making this call to Spirit. So honor the situation. This is where many have trouble. This is where we have to put the effort of will into it. This is the dawning of realization. This is the dawning of realization. See, we're not running away from it. Staying right there. This is the dawning of realization. This is the lifting of the veil. This is the apocalypse. This is the spiritual apocalypse we've been waiting for. The lifting of the veil. Here comes the dawning of realization. It's on its way. We're seeing it. nothing special is happening except we are honoring spirit. Honor the situation. Very important. This is the extra step that's so important. And if you're really determined, you're going to take this extra step. It's going to be, you know, your will be there. You'll be determined. You're not going to disengage. This is the dawning of realization. 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 Keep it conscious. Keep it conscious. See, keep it conscious. Not subconscious, conscious. That's what this honoring is doing, keeping it conscious. Where all of the other distractions of the conscious level here are wanting to go play, you say, no, I'm going to honor the dawning of realization, full consciousness here. This is the dawning of a fully conscious realization, a fully conscious realization. This is the dawning of fully conscious realization. I am into this. It's a statement saying, I am into this. That's what you're really saying. I am into this. I am into the dawn of realization. I am into this. I am into this. Make no mistake about it. I am into this. Don't say, well, I'll honor it later. I'll honor it later. I'll honor it now. Honor this now. Honor this now. Again, if we can't honor realization, what can we possibly honor? If we can't use our will for this, what can we possibly use it for? this phase, not a lot is requested of us except this effort of will to hang in there. So this is a different phase of the meditation. Several phases for sure. There's the push of the declarations, the tense consternation, the silence abiding with that consternation. Then there's the keep the momentum going, and then sometimes there is the huge breakthrough. There's the managing of your success of that breakthrough. After you've gotten through all of that, there's the honoring period where you honor tremendous effort, the tremendous response, actually. See, we asked, we expected, we trusted for a huge response, for a huge breakthrough. It arrived. So honor that fact. This is just, you know, don't let that slip by. Like, oh, yeah, okay. It's super important, right? We made the effort. We had the faith. We trusted in ourselves. We put forth the effort, determination, put the time, the patience in. The huge breakthrough occurred. So, this is, you know, tremendous. Tremendous. Honor our success. Honors our success. Honor our success. Keep this 2 hours or so. It's going there, but it doesn't feel that long actually at all. I was determined to do at least 2 hours here. Come what may, I was committed to it. You see, what when you commit to like a marathon, what happens? You commit to it. That's when you save yourself immeasurable suffering. Immeasurable delay, immeasurable delay. It's because that's how you give yourself the time, the space, time, space. You give yourself the opportunity to have the big breakthroughs because you know you're going to have time to let it settle down. You're going to have time to honor it. You're going to, you know, you're giving yourself the time. And so something inside of you says, okay, here it comes. Here it comes. Whereas if you just give yourself a little 5 minute, you know, no, it's not going to come about like that. Always, throughout history, it's all about, you know, giving yourself the time. Often meditations are 3 hours. Oftentimes programs are 3 hours. Now we're limited here by YouTube's editing function to 2 hours. 2 hours is also good. We were able to do it in 2 hours. Very, very well, but I did an hour of taping previously to this, so I've put in, you know, 3 intense hours already today, and we'll see. We'll probably have a late taping this evening too. And if you've noticed on the background, we've got the sun coming into the picture, the whole setting of the sun. It's gradually. The sun is setting on delusion, and the dawn of realization is here. The dawn of realization is now here. The dawn of realization is here now. The dawn of realization is here now. There's no question. It's conscious, you see. What we're doing is we're allowing it to surface to what we call consciousness here, instead of being beneath the surface. Consciousness. We are allowing it to surface. It's surfacing. It's dawning. It's dawning. Yeah, what a sweet time it is, right? So we give ourselves a celebration, honoring here of how sweet is this? How sweet is this? That, yeah, it, dawn of realization is here now. How sweet is that? Tremendous. Very memorable. Then no rush to rush away from it, to detach from it, and no hurry to detach from it at all. So let this permeate and get used to it, and we'll carry this vibe with us as we take care of now the odds and ends that need to be taken care of. People need to be fed. The cat needs to be let in. Very, you know, little things here and there. Okay, so the dawn of realization is now here. The dawn of realization is now here. Quite a lot to look forward to, right? A tremendous amount to look forward to. So, take a little rest, and then we'll see, get into what is there for us now. Okay, very great. That's it for this one.